Extensions of taking and sending. Taking and sending can be practiced in three different ways. The first is the traditional practice of taking in suffering and sending out happiness, coordinating the taking and sending with the breath. The second is to do the same practice while imagining that you are an expression of full awakening. For instance, you could identify with Avalokiteshvara, the embodiment of awakened compassion. This form of practice puts you deeply in touch with emotional resistance, while at the same time reducing the identification with emotional patterns. The third way is to practice taking and sending, knowing that you are not separate from what you experience. In this approach, you practice presence as a flow of energy, suffering coming in and happiness going out. All experience, whether it is suffering or happiness, is released in awareness. Up to this point, we have focused on the first, the basic practice of taking and sending. The other two methods develop naturally from the first. They are extensions of taking and sending into the domains of deity practice and the practice of direct awareness. Deity practice is one of the principal methods used in the Tibetan tradition to transform your experience of the world. Deity practice involves imagining that you are an expression of awakened mind, a deity, or, in Tibetan, a yidam. Avalokiteshvara, the embodiment of awakened compassion, is one such yidam, as are such deities as Vajrayogini, awakened passion, He Vajra, awakened anger, and Green Tara, awakened activity. Deities are highly symbolic representations of aspects of awakened mind that have appeared to past teachers in visions. These visions became the basis for meditation practices using that deity. When you imagine being the deity, the habituated patterns associated with your ordinary sense of self have no place to function. Because deities are all expressions of awakened mind, you, as the deity, have infinite resources to call upon in taking in the suffering of others and sending out happiness. You know that all suffering is empty, so you open fearlessly to the experience of the pain and the problems of others. Similarly, as the deity, you experience the bliss, clarity, and emptiness of mind, have infinite and inexhaustible capabilities, and embody compassion. Therefore, you can send infinite good fortune freely to all beings without the slightest sense of concern, regret, attachment, or fear. By embedding the practice of taking and sending in deity practice, you can do the practice more freely and more powerfully than when you are identified with your usual sense of who and what you are. Why, then, isn't taking and sending always practiced in the context of deity practice? Deity practice requires a willingness to allow your habituated sense of self to be replaced by a more subtle, open, and free way of relating to the world. Most people are not able to take that step without suitable preparation. Guidance by a qualified teacher is essential. In fact, taking and sending is often used as a preparation for the transition to deity practice. Once a student is trained in deity practice, however, he or she can use the deity as a basis for taking and sending. The third way to practice taking and sending is in the context of direct awareness. First, you must know direct awareness through your own experience. Then you do taking and sending to enhance your experience and understanding of emptiness and compassion. In presence, you know all that arises in experience as just that, an arising in experience. Thoughts are known to be thoughts, feelings to be feelings, sensations to be sensations. The level of energy and attention is such that direct awareness is not disrupted by the content of thought, feeling, or sensation. As associations are triggered, the arising of the associations is seen for what it is. Remain present and perceive the myriad threads of interdependent arising. Thoughts, feelings, and sensations release themselves as they arise because they are experienced completely in direct awareness. You experience taking and sending as a flow of energy. When energy arises as pain and suffering, take it in. When energy arises as pleasure and good fortune, send it out. Subject, the meditator, object, suffering and happiness, and practice, taking and sending, drop away, and taking and sending just flows.